This is NicoB, here with the Let's Play of Zero Escape, Zero Time Dilemma. Oh, yes, Picky Penguins, yes! After so many years of waiting, it's finally here. The final game in the Zero Escape trilogy. So I played 999 and Zero Escape over 3 years ago now. God, I can't, it's been that long already? God, the tumultuous development cycle this game has had is just, it seemed for a while there like it was destined to never be made. But fortunately, there was a massive support from fans for the game's creator, Kotaro Uchikoshi. And thanks to groups like Operation Bluebird, this game was finally able to get made and see the light of day. Oh, I'm so happy, guys. I'm so happy that we get to conclusion to this really awesome story. You know, I spent the last couple of days refreshing myself on what had happened in the series because it's been so long since I played it. There's so many moving parts, especially once, like, 999, I feel like was a lot simpler. But when it got to Zero Escape Virtue's Last Reward is when it got, like, holy shit, there's so many things going on. But it's really just, it's a very well-crafted, well-written story. But anyway, a few things I want to say off the bat here. Because I read some tweets from the developer that said they want me to sort of elaborate this, but yes, this is a playthrough of this game, Zero Time Dilemma, and so it will contain spoilers. And it's like, well, duh, that seems obvious, right? But some of the developers said they want you to be clear about it, so I just making that clear for you guys right now. Also, if you haven't played or seen the first two games, 9 Hours, 9 Persons, and 9 Doors, and Zero Escape Virtue's Last Reward, I highly, highly recommend that you don't watch this yet, all right? Either go play the other games yourself, or you can watch my playthroughs of it. I think you'll get the most enjoyment out of it if you understand a lot of the story that comes before it. Anyway, I just want to say thank you. Thank you so much to the Zero Escape fan base, the community, to Operation Bluebird, helping get this game to see the light of day. And of course, a big thank you to the game's creator, Kotaro Uchikoshi, who I just recently found out follows me on Twitter, for creating such an awesome story in a series that come to what I imagine will be a truly epic conclusion. So yeah, there's a lot of things that we can, I think, expect from this. So I'm pretty sure this game is going to take place it's essentially between the 999 and Zero Escape. It's going to be, since Zero Escape is technically in the future, and so this is probably going to take place during the Mars testing, in the Mars testing facility in the Nevada desert, where the Radical 6 virus is going to be released. So it's where Sigma and Phi have essentially time traveled through their minds to go and stop. I've seen, like, one trailer for this game, and it pretty much just showed, like, how the cutscenes were laid out, but I haven't seen any gameplay trailers. The only thing I really know for certain, I've seen the characters that are in here, and just based off what I can assume this game is about. A lot of things we're gonna uncover here. For example, what happened to Sigma? How did he lose his arms and his eye? I think that should happen in this game at some point. How did the Radical 6 virus get released? What exactly was going on with Luna's original, I guess the original person she was based off of? I think she's in here too. Just a lot of things. A lot of things are going to come to a head in this game. So anyway, let's get freaking started, guys. I actually saw you could actually choose between the English and the Japanese voice actors, which I think is pretty cool. But I'm sticking with the English, so. Yep, Nevada Desert, DCOM.
Hey, open up!
12/31/2028.
Who would
yep.
do this?
Shit. What's wrong with you?
Someone's one-night mistake.
A mistake?
Maybe Diana's.
This isn't the time for jokes.
Let me guess. That helmet can't come off, can it?
So creepy. I don't want it near me.
Oh, good. I can pause. All right. And wow, we're just kind of jumping right into it, aren't we? So I've heard about how the cutscenes in this game
are really different from the previous games, and I don't think there's really any more message boxes. It's kind of played out almost like a TV show. At least that's what I've heard.
Where the hell did this thing come from?
Forget it. Shouldn't we be trying to get out of here?
Impossible. This is a confinement room.
The bar's only open from the other side.
Nothing to do but ask whoever did this to let us out.
The mastermind's right there! That kid locked us up!
Really, dude? Alright, so we're seeing some familiar faces, and we're seeing some new faces here.
So he was the one who put these on us?
It's always gotta be a fucking wristwatch, isn't it?
It wasn't me.
It talks!
Nope, I'm pretty sure it's gonna be this guy right here. So that's Akane right there, I believe. Those two are new, I don't know them. There's, I believe, who Luna was based off of.
Don't you think there are moments when a single snail can make a world go extinct?
Make go extinct?
What the hell are you going on about?
Who are you?
I'm sure you'll determine that eventually.
Why are you doing this?
I require only you to take part in a game.
A game?
With the fate of you, me, and the human race in the balance.
Fuck that!
Let's get started, shall we?
Fuck that shit! And then just lands perfectly on its side.
Beneath my foot, there's a coin.
Oh.
One side of it is red, while the other side is blue. Which side of the coin is facing up? Make a guess. However, you only get one chance.
Do we get something if we get it right?
Yes, you get a free ice cream.
Ew, giddy!
I promise that I will lose all the hell.
And what if we're wrong?
You won't lose. You will have to stay in the game until at least six of you are dead.
What?
Let's go with blue.
It's red.
Right, red. It's gotta be red.
50-50 chance. The odds for each are the same.
Then we should vote. Wait! I can't believe you guys.
Kane's right. You're just going to do what he says?
What do you think, Carlos? You are the leader of this group. I will take your decision as everyone's final answer.
What are you talking about?
I'll let Carlos choose.
Pick red.
It's blue.
So what do you say, Carlos?
No, Carlos!
No pressure!
Time to choose, Carlos. You are that solitary snail. The fate of the world rests on your decision.
Oh, good. I would literally shit my pants, I think. Oh my god, what will it be? What will it fucking be? Hold on, I gotta... The music is a little bit loud. It's a little hard to hear the voices. Wow, we're really just going right into it, aren't we? We're like, just kind of curious to see. Oh, flowchart. Fragment flowchart, global flowchart, global flowchart, team select. Oh, no. Heads or tails, okay. What's the global flowchart? So you're telling me I could just end this right now? I choose blue. Yep, it's blue. All right, bye, everybody.
That's Zero Escape Time to Let, everybody. Wow, we did it. Sweet, sweet, sweet victory, yeah.
Status. Oh, okay. Oh, I see everyone's still alive. Okay, guys. What do I do? What do I do? All right, let's do this the smart way. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Catch a tiger by a toe. Here we go. Let it go. Boom. Your choice is made. You're dead. Wrong.
It's blue.
Come on, baby. Come on.
Yeah. Oh, in your face, asshole.
Congratulations! Damn it, he got it right. Well, guess that's it.
So, who was it who said it was red again?
Well done, Carlos.
Big teeth. Big tits, McGee.
Are you some kind of clairvoyant?
Just luck. I had a 50% chance. It's not too hard to get it right.
Hey, hold on a sec.
Okay, proud of myself.
Sure, you lucked out with your guess. But what if you had gotten it wrong?
What does it matter? Everything worked out fine.
So, are you going to make good on our deal?
Fear not. I'm a fair person. I promised to release you, and I shall. But before that, I apologize, but you must all sleep.
Sleep?
When next you wake, you will have forgotten everything that just happened here.
Why would we forget?
I wonder. Pleasant dreams.
Wow, that stuff worked fast.
I know. You're...
Wow. Payoff. Nevada Desert Decom. Is that all of us standing outside? 1231, 2028. Oh,
we're... Hey, hold on. Why are we outside?
Seriously? You just let us go? That's it, we did it. that was it. Okay, so I feel like I need to mention this. So the guy on the left there, that's Junpei. And then the one, and he's standing next to Akane. I think the Carlos guy, he's the one that I'm like really sort of like, it's a bit of a mystery because I believe he looks like Dio, right? So doesn't that mean he's another one of Left's clones? I would imagine then the Radical Six would be being released would have something to do with him. The girl with the giant boobs, don't recognize, looks like, but apparently she's probably related to Lotus and Alice, because there's always gotta be one chick who's scantily clad, who just has a giant pair of boobs. That guy with the bowl haircut, that guy just seems kind of crazy to me. I don't know, it seems like he's gonna end up being some kind of crazy serial killer or something. We had the little boy in the helmet, who I'm almost wondering if he's gonna end up being like Quark or something, but I don't really know how that would work, because was Quark put into one of those cooling pods? I don't think he was. I don't know, though. I think that might be too obvious. But then the other one, so that guy in the back row with the blue hair, this good old horny Sigma, baby. He's back, and I think he's been working out. God dang, he looks fucking chiseled, man. He also got a haircut. And he's also not an old man anymore. Although, he does have the mind of his old man. For any of you who have been keeping up the games, the mind of his old persona, essentially, the experienced one, the one that created all of the last game, essentially, should be in Sigma right now. Similarly, I think Fi should also have her experienced mind. And then, the red-haired girl is, I believe, who Luna was based off of. I think her name's Diane. It's kind of interesting, because I'm a little surprised that... It seems like Sigma is acting like I don't know what's going on, but he and Fi are probably just playing dumb, because I'm pretty sure by this point they've sort of mastered their the control of their abilities, so, and they learn to remember even after making one of those time leaps, you know?
I have no clue.
When I woke up, we were on the ground over there.
Huh? What is it?
Didn't we all have something attached to our left wrists?
I suppose we might have.
Coin.
Huh?
Nothing. I just saw an image of a coin flash in my mind. It was flipped and falling.
Come to think of it. Damn, I can't remember anything.
Me neither.
Neither can I.
It somehow feels like I made a bet with someone, but...
Someone?
What kind of bet?
I can't tell. Some of the voice actors seem different. I don't know if that's actually Troy Baker's voice, who's doing Sigma. I know he definitely did the original Sigma from the last game. I'm pretty sure Fi's voice actress is the same. She's the one who does. He did Igus and still like a whole bunch of other roles. Akane, I don't really know, honestly. We didn't really see her young in the last game for a very brief time. Junpei, I don't think we've ever heard Junpei talk, except when he was an old man. Carlos, though, if he really, I don't know, his voice actor sounds different from Dio's, I think. The original, Dio's voice actor was the guy who did Akihiko from Persona 3. I don't know if that's the same guy, though. And is that Luna's voice actress either? For Diane? I don't know. They sound pretty different. Also, I just gotta point this out. This game fair does remind me a bit of the last game in that the animations are a little stiff and kind of strange, a little strange looking. I mean, the sprites look good, but their face is kind of not quite right. It's not really that big a deal, but I remember the last game kind of being that way too.
Did we all forget what happened?
Hey, could I ask all of you something?
Anybody got a car?
Who is this kid?
Yeah.
It's not mine.
What the fuck? No. Oh my god. Are you serious? What the fuck? I'm sorry. That's just too fucking funny.
Yup, the end, Nico. Way to go. You beat Zero Escape zero times. However.
Wow, guys. Wow. That was truly an amazing, epic story we just went through. I'm gonna remember this story for the rest of my life. I just want to thank everyone who made this possible. Here we go. David Roach, Joni Good, Karen Strassman, Matt Mercer. I think that's who it is. Rachel Kimsey, Rena Strober. Matt Mercer does a good Troy Baker impression. I don't know. Oh, Kirk Thornton. He's the one who's doing the voice for that. The guy with the bowl haircut, I think. I knew I recognized that guy's voice. I cannot believe this. I was just joking, like, oh, it's not gonna happen. No, I guess that really is. You could literally end the game right there. But then, what's the point, right? But does that mean we prevented the Radical Six Fire from getting out? I feel like we couldn't have, right? There's gotta be more to it than just, well, I sent the right answer. Therefore, I'm done. Beginning of the end, or end of the beginning. CQD, end one. Way to go. Yeah, I'm the best, guys. Wow. I think it's the first time I've ever managed to get an ending for a game in the first 5 seconds. Remember that one RPG Maker game that was like, where you literally like each ending would last like 5 seconds. Like you'd hit a new game and then it was like, hello, who's there or something. Is anybody there? Now it's time to choose whose fate you will follow first. Select a team to continue the story. Oh! Oh. To advance the story, oh. Okay. Okay, well, okay. So there is, I thought I was just going to like jump back and make the decision to not do that now. I'm going to continue with Carlos. Actually, I was just curious, what's the flow thing here? Maybe I am jumping back. Each image you see here is a story fragment. Only one is available to you now, but more will unlock as the story unfolds. Select any unlocked fragment to continue the story. Ah, I see. When you find you are unsure of how to control something in the game, click the question mark at the top right to open the control guide. You can also press back on the controller or F1 on the keyboard. Interesting. Oh. So this game... These games have... It's all about the multiverse theory, essentially, I believe. They're all... Because every time we jump, it's a new timeline, essentially. Like Steins Gate. I don't think there's any one, like, central timeline. It all just kind of branches off. Like Temmyoji said at the end of the last game, he said, you know, it really doesn't matter whether we change the future or not, because that timeline, I think, will always exist. At least that's what I think. Okay, so will it play out differently if I'm as like Diane or Quark or any one of these? In that case, let's do Diane. Heads or tails? Does that mean she'll make the decision this time?
Time to choose, Carlos.
No, it's still Carlos's decision. Okay, well, let's go with red this time then, baby.
Choice is made.
It's red.
Why should it actually be red? Just a mind fuck me. Nope. All right. I remember it did that a few times in the last
sea,
last game.
Told you it was blue.
Shut up, Dupay.
Carlos, you asshole. You got it wrong.
Carlos.
What were you thinking?
Hey, wait a second. Carlos isn't the one to be blamed for all this.
Right. The person who started it is.
So?
The guy with the plague mask.
You should know already. You were wrong. So the game continues.
Until six people are dead, huh?
See, now, like... This is where it's like, who is that guy, though? Who's the Zero in this game supposed to be? So in the first game, it was June, or Akane here. The second game, it was Sigma, but old man Sigma, essentially. But who is this one gonna be? I have no idea. I honestly have no idea.
At least six. It's possible there may be more than that.
Could all be dead by the end of this.
Why don't we hurry and get this over with then?
Before you be-
Tube-J's like, I'm so fucking tired of this shit. I'm so tired of morphic genetic fields! Again?
Sleep?
When next you wake, you will have forgotten everything that just happened here.
Forget? But why?
There's no point to telling you now.
Just forget
you won't
anyway.
You remember anything in a moment. Pleasant dreams.
I like when you suddenly go, I feel fine. Ow, ow.
Oh, right, I landed right on my boobs.
It seemed like in that other one, like, Carlos had suddenly realized who Zero was. Doesn't it?
Oh, here we go. The virus. Behold. Holy chainsaw, Kane!
Oh, this is cool. This is really playing out like a TV show.
Zero Time Dilemma.
Okay, we got you warmed up now. Now for the actual game.
Carlos!
Akane.
Bastard! What the hell's going on? You brought all of us here!
No! It's not me!
Why does he immediately jump to him? Just because he's... Well, I guess because he's wearing a weird helmet? I guess they did that in the last game with Kay a lot, didn't they? They were like, you did this! You're suspicious because you're wearing massive armor.
Then what the fuck is that stupid thing on your head?
Let it go, Eric. No need to take it all out on the kid.
Mira?
I wonder what this is.
Okay, Eric and Mira.
Give it up, Diana. It's better that you don't force it off.
Why do you say that?
You should listen to it.
just trust us. Yeah, we've been through this shit like 800 times now.
I get the feeling she's seen it before.
Bracelet?
So have you, Sigma, you stupid fuck!
I know I have, but you know, gotta lead people on.
That's what it was called a year ago. Right, Akane?
Oh!
Junpei.
Hey, can we finally hook up like we always meant to do? And 999, we never did. All right, I'm gonna get giggity. Let's make a baby, Akane. Let's go find that elevator and go fuck.
Good morning.
Hi.
How are you feeling?
Ah, oh, good. You know.
I am Zero, the second Zero.
This in timeline order, but you know, I'm really the third and the you know, never mind.
Second.
Let me make one thing clear. This is a recording. So don't bother asking questions as I cannot answer them. I'd like to tell you an old story. 17 years ago, on a rainy morning, a woman went jogging in a large park. Her usual route led her to a fork in the road. Normally she'd run down the right path, but for some reason, this day, she chose the left. Along the way, she bumped into a senior citizen she saw every day. Surprised to see her, they asked, "Why did you come this way today?" This was her reply. "Because there was a snail." Her body was discovered a few hours later.
Well, what the? What? Wait. Okay, you kind of lost me partway there. All right, so she ran into someone she runs by every day? And then the guy's like, why did you come down here?
Because there was a snail, all right? I hate snails. He was blocking my path. He was...
Actually, that's like Breakfast at Musashi, right? You guys remember that? It was a massive fucking snail.
And I just didn't have any salt with me. And the guy's like,
oh, okay. Well, you're gonna die today, bitch.
Murdered. They found her in some bushes along the left path.
That'll teach you to run on my path.
Life is simply unfair. Don't you think?
What the hell is all this nonsense?
It's the same for all of you. The pull of an unjust fate carried you along to this moment. Only to find yourselves in this bomb shelter, 50 meters below ground.
Wait, what?
As you can see, this place is divided into three sections. Carlos, Akane, and Junpei, you three are in Ward C. You will henceforth be referred to as C-Team.
Okay.
Your leader shall be Carlos.
Yeah! No, that's definitely gotta be one of the Dio clones, one of Left clones. He looks too much like him.
Next is Q, Mira, and Eric. You are located in Ward Q. Your name will be Q-Team. As evidenced by the name, the leader is Q.
Hey, wait!
Really? Little boys? So yeah, he's even called Q. So right, like, Quark? Is that you, Cinderblock? Are you in there? Is that you under that helmet? I don't know, that seems like it would be just too obvious though, right?
Is this a joke?
And finally, Diana, Phi, and Sigma. Ward D is where the three of you are. Diana is the leader. That makes you the D team.
It's interesting. I feel like they're sort of churning our expectations on his head a bit here, you know? You would think, okay, well, on the team with Junpei, wouldn't Junpei be the leader, right? No, it's just Carlos, the Dio guy? And then in the other team, instead of one of the adults being the leader, it's the small boy. And in this one, you know, last two games was Phi or Sigma. They were the main characters. And nope, instead it's Diana there.
You may wander as you like, as long as you remain within your respective wards. There is a time limit, however.
Ah, shit.
90 minutes. Once 90 minutes are up, an injector in your bracelet will activate. An anesthetic and an agent to erase your memories will be administered.
I see. Okay, that's what
memory erasing drugs?
It's out. Knock
as
yourself.
As a result, you'll all fall into a deep, uninterrupted sleep. But you will also forget everything that occurred in those past 90 minutes.
What?
The bracelet has an additional function. A watch. Pressing the buttons on each side simultaneously will display the time.
12:10.
Today is December 31st, New Year's Eve. The year turns over in less than half a day. Unfortunately, very few of you will find yourselves able to welcome a new 2029. Take a look at the door. It's clearly marked with an X. Beyond this X door is a hallway with an elevator. Riding the elevator up will take you above ground. There's no other way out. The door is easy enough to open. Simply
okay.
Obtain the X passes and enter them into the input device beside it. 6 X passes are needed for it to unlock.
It's always that way. They've all been that way, essentially, right? In the first game, you had to get to open the big 9 door, and then last game, was it also a 9 door? It was like a 9 vault. It was just like a big, heavy thing, but you had to earn like a certain number of points. Was it 9 points? Was that right? If you lost too many points, you would die, but if you got all the points, you would open the door and leave, or whatever.
One X pass will be announced every time someone dies.
Oh. Fuck.
In blunter terms, if 6 of you die, the rest will gain all of the passwords and will be able to open the X door.
This is bullshit.
So then 3 would be able to get out.
One caveat. The door remains open for only 30 seconds.
Oh, again!
Once that passes, it will automatically close and never open again.
I'm sorry, but why do you have to do it this way?
Oh, yes. With this information, surely some of you at this point are thinking, how can I kill 6 people?
What? No one would...
I'll give you one opportunity. By majority vote, determine one team to execute.
What?
Shit.
Do you see the computer in the corner of the room? The team names of your newfound enemies will be displayed on that monitor. Choose the team you've decided to eliminate. Each team gets one vote. The leader must submit it for the group. Your deadline is 13:30. Any team that hasn't voted before the time limit is up shall be penalized 2 votes. The group with 2 or more votes will lose. Every member of that team will be executed.
Fuck me.
Let us begin. This is the decision game, a game of fate. The lives of you, me, and the human race hang in the balance.
But on the bright side, guys, they have a mini bar. Let's go get fucked up before we die. Time to get crunked, everybody. Might as well, right? A grain of sand. That's right, a grain of sand in an hourglass of many different motherfucking timelines. I didn't really seem like it made any difference that I had picked her team there. But I think from this point on it will, because then I'll be deciding. God, that seems like it'll be really confusing then. That'll make like a whole bunch of choices, because if I go to this team and make a vote, or go to this team and make some vote, or go to this team and make a vote. But that's three different options for each of these teams, right? Unless each team always picks the same thing.
My brain.
All right, well then let's hop to Carlos again. It's interesting how they're doing this. So we're coming up to a branch of only two paths, really? I'd imagine it'd be more than that. Because I'm guessing the option is to, if you don't vote, then you'll get penalized and we'll die. Execution C. If we vote for, maybe if we tie or something, or nobody gets the majority, we'd all die. Prep room. Decontamination room. Control. So these are the rooms in where Carlos's group is. Power room. I guess. Infirmary. It's always a fucking infirmary, isn't there? And a pantry, too. Bacon and eggs. Shut up, Junpei.
This is the last room.
Yes.
Oh, can we get the rec room?
Everywhere we could.
App of Word C stored in file.
It's just as Zero said, huh? There's no way to get out, except by opening the X door.
50 minutes left until the vote deadline.
Don't tell me you want to vote.
How can we not? If we refuse, C team gets two votes automatically. We'll die.
But
again, I feel like Akane has got to be playing ignorance here, right? She has to be. I mean, she knows all about this shit. She's been playing this shit for years. But she's different, right? She's different from how Junpei and Fi are. Sigma and Fi are. Because they have, like, the ability to jump through, like, time leap, essentially, but into their consciousness. While Junpei and Akane can sort of, like, telepathically speak to one another, right? That's how Junpei was able to do that through time. And I believe Akane, can she like see the future too? It's like different kinds of Esper powers.
Hey, do you think this could be part of the experiment? DCOM's whole psychological test?
Nope.
What? Why?
That mask guy called himself Zero. I have no clue why he's here, but he's for real.
Yeah, I think the voice actor for Carlos there is different from... Maybe they couldn't get the original guy to come back. The guy did Akiko, I guess. Or maybe he isn't related, but he looks too much like him, in my opinion. I'm pretty sure Dio had blonde hair and green eyes, didn't he?
So that means he's actually willing to kill off a whole team?
Yeah.
But how?
He said that there's an anesthetic in our bracelets, right? So we'll be sleeping, and then bam! Or maybe... There's a bunch of different ways.
Junpei, look, you need some sun, man. You're pale as hell.
If only there was a way to contact someone on the other teams.
Why would you need to reach them? What, you're planning on begging them not to vote C-team or something?
Well, no, but I thought, why not spread out the votes?
What do you mean?
Remember what Zero said? The group with two or more votes will lose.
Yes, that's what I was thinking. So if we all vote... You know, if I vote for this team, then they vote for one other team, and then they all vote for the other one votes for another. The other team makes a perfect little triangle. It's all each person has one vote. I kind of imagine if we did that, though, then we would like just all die or something.
I get it. Maybe C team could vote for D team for Q team, and Q team for C team. Then all the teams would have one vote each.
Right.
And that'd make it a three-way tie, and no one would have to die.
How do we make sure they know to do it?
Hey,
lounge.
Mira!
Eric! Diana!
Phi! Sigma! Can you hear us?
It's not working.
Damn it!
Hey, Akane, why don't you try using the morphogenetic field?
Wow, we're just gonna jump right into that, huh? I'm sorry, I thought we were gonna continue to act stupid for a little longer.
That's right, I gotta give him the Junpei voice, right? He was the original one. Junpei was the original Junpei voice.
Akane, alright, I'm tired of dicking around, alright? Let's just do our superpower thing. And then we'll get in this elevator and have sex like we were always meant to.
Huh? Morphogenetic field?
Morphed what, Ibana?
There's always some writing on the wall there, too.
Where I treat too. What's this supposed to mean?
The game will end, and something about two people? I guess the tough part is figuring out treat. If it's like trick or treat, then maybe it means there's a reward or a gift or something.
But it could also mean treatment, which would imply being cared for.
Either way, it doesn't make sense.
Hey.
Nah, those are going to be way too basic. The last game had a message written on the wall, right? But it ended up being some, like, way more complicated.
Anyone know what this thing could be?
A box?
What's inside of it?
Maybe some kind of white smoke.
Force quit box.
You've heard of it, Carlos?
Huh? Urashima Taro, right? Japanese folklore. Something about jumping through time, I think.
This label says force quit box.
What's that?
Looks like there's a keyboard.
There's probably a password that goes there.
Then something ends if you punch it in?
But what, though?
Maybe the game Zero's making us play.
Wait. You really think Zero'd put something that easy here?
It seems like it wouldn't even have to be a box for that.
Didn't think it'd work.
Just pressing random buttons isn't going to solve anything.
I kind of didn't even, like, answer him when he brought up the morphogenic fields. It was just kind of like... Just kind of gave him a look, like,
shut up!
So, what now?
What can we do?
Maybe we should just get this voting business over with.
Junpei.
No, we still have some time.
Come on, man, you're supposed to be the leader here.
I also thought Carlos, you'd be a giant asshole, because Dio was a giant asshole.
How the hell did we get into this mess anyway? Do you guys have any ideas?
Well, probably. What to ask? Who is Zero? What is Zero's purpose? What is your relationship? I feel like this is the important one. I mean, I know, but... I feel like Carlos might
Akane
should know.
Kurashiki. Junpei Tenmyoji. You're both Japanese, right?
How do we know everyone's, like, name like this? Do we... I mean, I think we mentioned everyone's first names, but how does he know their last name?
Yes.
And you both lived in Japan when you were kids. You even went to the same school. So you're childhood friends.
What?
I told you that.
Yeah.
Sigma. He mentioned it back in DCOM. We all lived in close quarters in that facility for 5 days.
Oh, there we go.
Information spreads fast. So, whose idea was it for you to join?
Huh?
The DCOM experiment. You two signed up together, right?
No, we didn't. We did this on our own.
Wait, you're telling me you guys just happened to bump into each other at DCOM?
It wasn't a coincidence. It was inevitable. Why did you subject yourself to this circus?
I didn't mention it before. I kind of really need a lot of cash. They said they'd give us 500,000 if we joined up.
What the fuck? Okay, Carlos, I think you should be able to recognize this game. Wow, this ad in the newspaper says, join our experiment, we'll give you $500,000 per hour. Wow, that sounds just too good to be true. If it seems too good to be true, Carlos, then it probably freaking is.
Huh. Color me surprised. Thought a hero of justice had no need of money.
A what?
Didn't you say you're a firefighter?
a really good one. You've faced off against danger and saved a whole bunch of people. Sounds like a hero to me.
I just have good instincts. Doesn't seem to matter where I find myself. They're pretty good at telling me which path has death at the end.
Ugh. I'm liking how they're doing it. It is. It's very much like a TV show, you know? Every line is voice acted. There's no message boxes. The dramatic panning of the camera and stuff. It's cool. I mean, the sprite might be a little stilted, but I don't know. I think it's good. And, you know, the voice acting is good, too. Who is Zero?
Who is Zero?
To be accurate, you should probably ask, who is the second Zero instead?
Then that means there has to have been a first one, right?
Yeah, there is.
You know him?
Sorta. I brought it up earlier.
Sorta, she's right there!
Bracelet a lot like this one has been strapped to my wrist before. It happened last year. Akane and I were trapped somewhere.
It's only been a year since the 999 game? Shit. I didn't realize, okay. Jubi looks a lot older though, doesn't he?
The person responsible back then was named Zero.
But I don't think that one has anything to do with this one.
It's gotta be connected.
Just please. Believe me.
She's right.
I don't get it still.
Welcome to the club, Carlos.
Why is Zero doing this?
To make us play a game, right? This decision game or whatever.
With the fate of mankind on the line.
So it's true.
Do you know something, Akane?
I think if we end up losing this game, we're all going to die.
And probably the whole human race is going to die. It's all has to do with the Radical Six being released. I'm curious, like, what point we're going to counter it. How did it get? Is it going to get administered or what?
6 billion people will.
Yep.
So what Sigma said back then up in DCOM was.
At this rate, 6 billion people will die.
Yes. What Sigma said is the truth. Have you ever heard of the term reverie syndrome? What causes it is unknown. Neither the nerves nor the brain have abnormalities. But somehow, this disease causes you to stop reacting to a variety of stimuli. I've heard there are people from all over the world who have become affected by this.
Hey, hold up.
Huh?
How does this and what we were talking about before go together?
Shouldn't you know already?
Huh?
A crisis. Mankind is currently facing what is clearly an unprecedented crisis. Those affected are sensing it's coming.
Wait, reverie syndrome? Is that what the Radical Six is or something?
Reverie syndrome.
You've heard of it?
Yeah, kinda.
Huh.
Do you hear something?
1300 hours, 7 minutes.
Over there.
Where did you come from?
Oh, look at the little... Aren't you little scruffy doggy? Well, hello, little scruffy doggy. What are you doing here? Are you playing the game with us? Hopefully you don't die with us. Oh, he's got a little something on his neck, too.
It's a flask of booze.
Looks like you made it here using this vent.
Oh.
Does that mean it's connected to the surface?
Who's a smart little scruffy doggy? Who's a smart little scruffy doggy?
I don't think so. A vent to the surface would defeat the purpose of a bomb shelter.
Yeah.
So he came from another ward then.
It's too dark, I can't see anything. But Ward Q is down that direction, right?
Okay.
Think you can fit in there, Akane?
No, there's no way.
Someone likes cake too much.
She likes my cake too much, if you know what I mean. Yeah, high five, Clarlos. Wait, what? Yeah!
Oh, I know. Let's cut off Junpei's arm. He should be able to fit through then.
Huh. Hey!
Junpei's become really sort of like, just don't give a shit anymore.
I've entered Neko emo mode. Neko emo
Eric!
Mode.
Eric!
No answer, huh?
Who's that goddamn little bugger?
Did they steal you away from DCOM too?
But why the dog?
Maybe they felt bad about leaving him alone up there?
Baloney. You really think Zero'd do us any favors?
Hold on. I think I got an idea that may work. This here, this case, it holds medication, doesn't it?
Uh-huh. It's empty.
So they usually, like... It's like with the big St. Bernard's dogs would carry, right? Except they, but I thought they carried like a thing of like alcohol, essentially, because it makes you feel warmer, even though in reality it's actually making you colder, and it's actually a really bad idea to drink alcohol. But I don't know. At least back in the olden days.
Did that bastard Zero take the meds?
I still think this could work. We can use it. Wait a sec.
A beer coaster and a pen.
I found them on the counter of the bar.
I see. He's gonna send a note to the other group.
There's something written on it.
Oh, I did that.
Hello, Carlos here. C-Team is voting for D-Team. So D-Team should vote for Q-Team and Q-Team for C-Team.
Oh!
I think if anyone's gonna fuck us over, it's gonna be the one with that guy with the bull haircut. I don't know. He seems kind of unhinged.
You're going to put it in the case and have Gab go through the vent.
How do you know the dog's name?
Cross your fingers he can get to Q-Team.
You really think it'll be that simple?
So we shouldn't?
Well, I guess we don't have anything to lose. Why don't we give it a shot?
God, you're serious buzzkill, Jumpy. What happened to you, bro?
What did you throw?
Cheese.
Go get the cheese. Oh boy, that's good. That's gonna go straight to my thighs. That's gonna make me a little gassy, but all right.
The coaster. It was over there on the counter.
Why don't we just toss in some ketchup and pickles too? Maybe next time he comes back, he'll be a hot dog.
I'm on a roll today.
Carlos's face.
Are you fucking shitting me now? Right now?
It was a joke.
Shut up, Junpei.
5 minutes left.
Gab's not come back.
Let's just vote, Carlos.
Assholes, my own piece of cheese!
Like I said, if we forfeit.
I know!
Hey, there's one thing we can do.
What is it?
You remember what you wrote on the Gab letter?
The what?
The message we sent the furry pigeon to deliver? C-Team is voting for D-Team, so D-Team should vote for Q-Team and Q-Team for C-Team.
Yeah? So what?
So, vote for Q-Team instead.
What? Junpei, you can't be suggesting... If we do that, they'll end up with two votes and...
Yep, Q-Team will be out. Granted, this whole thing is assuming our initial plan works. The note makes it to D-Team, and Diana votes the way we want her to.
Jeez, Junpei. Wow, what happened to Junpei, man?
I've seen some shit, man. You don't understand. Dating Akane has really fucked my brain.
What? Why? Why would we do that? I mean... Why would he immediately jump to let's do that now, instead of just, why don't just go with the plan we were gonna do?
Think about it for a second. Six people have to die or we're never getting out of this bomb shelter.
Oh.
Those are the rules of the decision game, according to Zero.
Then why did we even come up with the thing we said? Just, was Junpei just intending from the beginning to fuck somebody over?
Balancing the votes won't do us any good.
I guess
we'll just
so.
We'll end up falsely prolonging someone's death.
Junpei...
deadline to vote is in 3 minutes.
Please go choose who you want to die.
Vote for Q Team.
No, you can't!
Time to decide.
Well, you know, sorry, but fuck you, Junpei, all right? I'm gonna believe in them, even though I'm probably gonna regret this.
D-D-D-D team.
Your vote has been accepted.
Ah, I was worried you weren't going to do it, Carlos.
Thank you for voting with Decision Game Incorporated. We hope you have a lovely, short-lived day.
You'll see, Akane. Just because we did what we said we would doesn't mean this will work. Hell, we don't even know if our note reached the other teams or not. And even if it did, there's no guarantee they did what we asked. Two possibilities will come out of this. The three members of D-Team will die, or it's our heads on the chopping block.
90 minutes have passed. Your time has ended. Sleep well, as the next game will begin when you awake. Unfortunately, the team who receives two votes will be unable to participate. One final thing. You've gone through with the vote exactly as I commanded. You deserve a reward for obeying. The memory loss drug will not be injected into the freeway. When you next wake, those who survived will be able to regret the decision I made.
Huh. So we did it the right way, he's saying? But the other ones didn't? Is that what he means? He said they're gonna regret the... Oh, I have a memo, just like I did last time, for... What's the log? Will not be ejected. When you next wake, those who survive will be able to regret the decision they made. Oh, the memory loss will not be ejected. Huh. Okay.
As all members of a single team will perish as a result of the vote you entered. Pleasant dreams.
Okay, so we're knocked out, but we're not going to lose our memory.
Hoo-wee!
This shit's stressing me out! Okay, well, number cleared. Number clear, what does that mean? Like, have I done everything in there or something? Is that what it means? Oh, I see. So we have, oh my god, we have flowcharts within flowcharts. Decisions upon decisions upon decisions. Alright, well, might as well continue with Carlos and crew here. Right? Or can I not? Oh, if I do, I go back. Alright, well, let's go see what Diane's group's up to then. Execution D. So we all have our own little mini bar. That's very
when curious. Hate oozes calamity. So a moment when hate becomes calamity, huh?
And maybe the three. I bet there's, and then Q Team's gonna have something else written there, right? Will it form like a complete sentence if we put it all together?
I wonder what that means.
Actually, that's right. No, the one from the last game, I just remember, it was a acronym, right? For something?
Beats me.
Maybe it's not supposed to have a meaning. Huh? It's an anagram.
Yeah, there we go. When I said acronym, anagram, that's what I meant to say.
You reorganize the letters into another sentence.
I've done this shit before.
Why do you think it's an anagram? I've seen something like this before. In another place. Anyway, where's Sigma?
Go, go, Horny Sigma!
Damn it! Must find Slutty Clover! She's here somewhere, I know it!
What are you looking at?
A box.
What kind of box?
Well, I'm looking into it because I don't know.
It looks like something's written on it.
Force quit box.
That's interesting.
I see a keyboard on it too.
Use this keyboard to input a password and force something to stop. Is that what this means?
What does it stop?
Well, the obvious answer would be the game Zero is making us play.
Then we should try it. I shouldn't have thought it would be that easy.
We need a hint.
Maybe it says something on the underside.
Yeah, I don't think that's I don't think that's Luna's original voice actress either. Oh, that's kind of a shame. Really? It would shock me that they wouldn't be able to get those original people. I mean, not blaming the developers. I imagine, you know, either the voice actors were busy or they wanted more money.
Nope. Won't budge.
Is it heavy?
Heavy doesn't even begin to cover it. I doubt it's made out of anything from Earth.
Well, yeah. You are getting up there, Sigma.
Shut up, Fi.
Damn, Sigma. I didn't realize you were actually kind of hot when you were young.
I know. That makes all that horny shit I was spouting in the last game seem really, really creepy.
What are you saying? My body's still got it.
I'll just give it a try.
I love you, Luna.
You weren't lying.
Please don't die in this game.
See? I told you.
This is the map for Ward D, right?
Looks like it.
Lounge, gymnasium room, locker room, healing room, transporter room.
We can go wherever we want, so long as it's within this ward?
Manufacturing.
Yes. That's what Zero said.
Yeah, we haven't even gotten into any puzzles yet. Prep room. I feel like the reason they have a decontamination room, right, is for the Radical Six stuff. Transporter room. Oh! Manufacturing! It's the golems, or the golems, or whatever. Trash disposal room.
All right.
Locker room.
I checked all the rooms from top to bottom, but...
You didn't find any exits?
Okay, here's the plan, guys. You girls go in the locker room and get changed, and I'm gonna go watch you through that hole in the wall.
Obviously, we are in a bomb shelter, after all. If there were several exits, it'd defeat the purpose it was built for.
So Zero told the truth.
Then opening the X door is the only way out. Mira!
You guys want to play some basketball?
Can you hear me?
Carlos! Akane! Tenmyoji!
There's no point. We wouldn't hear a drunk toga party at full volume on the other side.
I think we need 6 passwords to get this door to open, right?
Yeah, that X-Pass thing.
For every 1 person who dies, 1 password will be revealed.
Is that... true, though?
Sigma, why don't you try dying once?
I politely but firmly refrain.
What about you, Diana?
Well, we'll come back anyway.
Fine, you and I have died like at least 80 times already.
Hey, no.
Figured.
good old smug Lufi.
What's up?
Who is Zero will help come the way Sigma talks.
This may be somewhat rude of me to say, but the way you talk, Sigma, is, a little unusual.
mean, you kind of sound like Troy Baker, but...
No. I'm budget Troy Baker.
Oh.
I kid though. Matthew Mercer does, honestly, it does an excellent Troy Baker impression. I think Troy Baker, because he's been really popular, really hot these days. I think he might have just gotten really expensive.
He's getting too high and mighty.
Matthew Mercer though, he actually has his own YouTube channel. He does like the Dungeons and Dragons thing, right? That guy's got a fucking killer voice. That guy's awesome. He did like. Yeah, oh my god, I've watched some of it. It's really entertaining to watch.
Forgive him. The age of his mind and his body are completely different.
Oh, he mentioned that back at DCOM. That his consciousness had come back from the year 2074.
What? Okay, so... Damn, we talked about a lot of this stuff already. I thought we were just hiding everything from other people. I don't know. No, we're just gonna tell... Yep, got the mind of an old man, but the libido of a young, horny teenager.
That's correct. That's why I know what will happen in the future. I must have spent the past 5 days warning all of you. If nothing changes, mankind will be destroyed. Kane, Fi, and I infiltrated DCOM to stop all that from happening.
Fi? Is this true?
Well, would you believe me? If I said that it was.
Then why are all of us trapped in this strange place? If you know the future, then you could have prevented this.
We had no idea what events went down inside the DCOM facility.
You know, I went back and reread the secret ending that was to the Zero Escape, and there was a scene where we take control of what appears to be Kyle Klein, the clone of Sigma, but it turns out it actually isn't him, it's somebody else in his consciousness, and that's where it sort of gets very fourth wall breaking. Like it sounds like Akane says we're like the someone who doesn't have to follow the rules of their world. Like, I don't know, it sounds like they're talking directly to the player. But there was a point where we asked Fi what happened at the Mars testing facility. She said, I can't tell you that, because if I do, it'll change the future or something. And I'm guessing if that is supposed to be like us, and we are a part of this equation, then, you know, that's the reason why she'd want to tell us that. It's like, well, then we'll know what happens, right? Feed the whole point of the game.
Nor did we know anything about what's going to happen in this shelter.
Who do you think Zero is? Do you guys know who Zero is?
No, I haven't the foggiest. But they called themselves Zero. At the very least, they know about what happened a year ago.
What are you...
There's one more thing for sure. Think about it. Why was Zero's speech to us pre-recorded? There's got to be a very big reason why things can't be in real time. There are two possibilities. They've already bit the bullet. Or...
Zero is among us.
But we know that's not true, right? Because... Well, they don't remember that, though. That's right, because they lost their memory when they fell asleep. But we know that's not true, because we saw them all together with Zero, like, literally standing in front of them. Will help come? Probably not.
Do you think someone will come help us?
Like who?
Maybe the DCOM experiment staff?
Sorry, but that's pretty unlikely. Remember? The staff stationed in DCOM can't communicate with us right now. The simulation is attempting to stay true to an actual Mars mission.
It's at least 6 months between Earth and Mars. In that time period, Earth will have rotated halfway around the Sun. Which means...
By the time the spaceship reaches Mars, the Earth is behind it.
With the star in the way, we can't send a signal.
That's the lead-up. We've been doing experiments for the past 5 days.
Transmissions will re-establish on December 31st at 23:30, which leaves us with more than 10 hours.
There's no point in hoping for a rescue to come before then.
Pretty sure the DCOM staff won't notice any problems until that time.
You guys are like siblings. You're totally in sync.
We're not.
By the way, Sigma, you wanna do it in the broom closet?
Sure, why not?
Why did this have to happen to me? I should have never listened to Rebecca.
Rebecca?
She's the head nurse at the hospital where I worked.
Okay, so she was. I was wondering if the original Luna was actually going to be a nurse or a doctor herself.
Oh, right. You did say you were a nurse.
I joined the DCOM experiment because Rebecca suggested it to me. She told me that they were searching for a nurse willing to participate. Well, to be honest, there is another reason why I decided to join.
Oh, hey, buddy!
Hey, Scruffy!
Why is Gab here?
I think he came through the vent.
See anything?
No, it's too dark.
So I guess we must have met the dog, Gab, then, during the 5 days as well. That's how we know its name.
You're up, Fi.
You want me to go in there? It's clearly impossible.
You sure?
I won't repeat myself.
Oh, actually, now I think about it. So, he's able to erase our memories of just that, like, those few moments we saw him, but we still retain the memories of the 5 days we were there together. So we don't lose all of our memories of our time here. Huh.
My boobs are D's.
Don't you lie to me!
Your pants are on fire.
It's true.
It seems to me they've gotten a full size larger than the last time you told me.
It's been 45 years. Growing is natural.
Why are your clothes still on?
You were just sleeping.
Could I interrupt? What is this?
Is that a coaster?
Something's written on it. Hello, Carlos here.
There we go.
D-Team is voting for D-Team. So D-Team should vote for Q-Team and Q-Team for C-Team. And someone else wrote...
Q-Team, got it.
Get it. By spreading out the votes, they're suggesting we make it a tie.
Looks like Q-Team agreed.
Seems so.
I guess Gab passed through Ward C to Ward Q and ended up here. It'll work! Now none of the teams will have to die!
I wonder about that.
What?
The deadline to vote is in 3 minutes.
Damn, we don't have much time. We need to head over to the voting device.
What exactly did you mean earlier, Fi?
I'm saying it could be a lie.
Do you mean that Q-Team is planning to betray us?
No, I doubt it. That's what they intended. They didn't have to send Gab. They'd only have to decide to vote for D-Team.
Then you mean...
There's a chance that C-Team will betray us. Maybe they're saying they'll vote for D-Team, but actually vote for Q-Team.
Why would they do that?
To make us choose Q-Team. If you think it's a good idea to spread out the votes, then your choice is easy, right? I'm just saying. It's a possibility.
Fi is always a suspicious one.
Deadline to vote is in 1 minute.
What should I do?
The fact that Gab showed up means that we can assume Q-Team's voting for C-Team. So we have no choice but to choose Q-Team. Otherwise...
Our single vote could cause the death of all of C-Team.
No pressure, Diana! I don't want to do this!
Alright. Well, I was over there and I made my decision and I chose to stick with the plan, so... Just have Dio on his head. It's interesting. We're taking point of view, different points of view of this game. That's
your vote has been accepted.
Well, that was a good choice.
Wide variety of decisions. Okay?
So long as Gab's note was the truth,
all we could do was trust them.
I suppose.
90 minutes have passed. Your time limit has ended. Sleep well, as the next game will begin when you awake. Unfortunately, the team who receives 2 votes will be unable to participate. One final thing. You've gone through with the vote exactly as I commanded. You deserve a reward for obeying. The memory loss drug will not be injected into the premium.
Okay, so this recording here goes to everybody who did what they were supposed to. I'm guessing. Okay. So it wasn't just, like, the other group. I forgot, it wasn't like he'd come on the screen and said to us live, like, you three are the only ones who did it right. Okay, I see.
When you next wake, those who survived will be able to regret the decision. As all members of a single team will perish as a result of the vote you entered. Pleasant dreams.
You see Sigma just land right on top of Fio.
God damn it, Sigma!
Oh, it was an accident. Oh, I'm sorry.
I see, and then finally I'll have to make a decision here. But I think I'm going to have to say that one for next time, guys. I'm so happy. I'm so happy to be playing this game. So happy to be continuing the epic Zero Escape story. Anyway, if you guys are as excited about this series as I am, please leave a like and a favorite. It really does help me out. And subscribe if you're not already to become a Picky Penguin aboard the SLP, where the days are always sunny and the bits are always funny. And as always, guys, till next time, stay classy.
Oh my god, I'm so excited for Zero Escape. Even though I haven't seen any of the other games, I have no idea what's going on.
You gotta catch up on the series, Bernie.
Too many videos, Nikos. It's gonna take me 3 years to get through all those. It's gonna take me as long as you had to wait for this game to come out before I see all of them.
Bernie, in order to be a real Piggy Penguin, you must watch every series.
Ah, that's freaking bullcrap. I ain't got no time for that, Nico. I've got work to do.